Hello and welcome to another episode on the Comcraft server. Now, I would like to first tell you something. This, even though it looks exactly like the server that you saw before, you'd be wrong! Because, wow, that's some slow swinging I got going there. So this server now is on a third-party site called Cubed Host. So now we got the, oh, there you go, it says world save, so it saves the world for me. It's just a lot of less work that I actually have to do. And the more important thing is I was running this off of my computer. Now, I said this whole thing, the server, the running a server, the getting people to join, the YouTube thing, this is all a work in progress. And I do believe this is the next step up because when, I have to confess, when we had this on my computer, there are some issues. I needed to restart my computer or just turn it off because it's been on for like days on end. And there was a time where we had an outage. And guess what? Guess what happens when you have an outage when you run a server? Computer goes down, server goes down, people who joined aren't happy. So we decided to change that. So if you would like to start your own server, I would suggest you go to cubedhost.com and start there. It's $10 and you get all of this. Notice that every single thing is exactly the same. I'm talking about our headhunter that we have going on to the, oh, if I put a, I don't think I have the wood, but I can still show you. Let's go in here, make a sign right quick. One of those, six of, one, two, three, four, five, six. Six of these, back to the chesty thingy. Because let's say I really want to keep track of all my stuff. Go here, three of those, and bam, put a sign on this. Now, you'll see it says edit message, but if you just put done, you'll see that it says private, the name of whatever your name is in Minecraft, and only I can access this box now, and that's because of a plugin called Locket. Same with this one. I mean, I guess it won't work for me, but, I mean, I guess it'll work for me because, you know, I own these boxes. But if somebody came in and was like, oh, cool, free boxes, nope, can't get in. And I love it. So this is a good step in the right direction. I, once again, have to admit, it wasn't as easy as I thought because when I started this, the nether was gone. And that's a lot of work that we put into the nether. I mean, this is a lot of work, but this was, actually, this was the easiest part. Getting the nether back was a pain, but I finally got it back. We got the plugins in, and I'm sure more plugins will come, but we'll try to keep it as vanilla as possible. And I guess that's it on that. So what are we doing today is I want to show you what's down here. Now, I do believe if I fall down there, actually, let's eat some food. I don't care about actually falling. Is there a safer way down there? Probably not. But remember this whole thing right here. If you see the hoppers, it goes down and it's supposed to go over. But what we're going to do is we're going to have it drop all down. Spit out items into, it'll go into a hopper, the hopper will spit the items, it'll carry all the way through on ice to go about right here, no, exactly right here, and then it will push it over into a glass item elevator. It'll come up to about where the stairs are into a bunch of chests over here so that I can take them and put them on what floor I desire. So, let's go ahead and drop down. Please don't kill me. Good. All right. That's fine. So here we go. Now we are directly under where the hopper line is. There should be nothing in there for the moment. But we're going to... Actually, we can go ahead and build this on camera. We're going to actually grab the stuff because I just realized I don't have it. Then we'll get back to that. Yeah, I had to clear out an area because I needed the space over here. It's not going to be this big. What I'm going to do, actually, is I'm just going to go ahead and show you how to build part of this here, since this is going to be extremely easy. We're going to go ahead and put the ice down here and then pull it over here. And then we'll go to our redstone testing world to show you how to make the item elevator, because that's a little more complicated than what I'm about to do here. So, God, I love seeing it say saved world. Every time I do, it makes my heart smile. So what we're actually going to do is we're going to kill this one. We're going to go ahead and get a hopper. I mean, dropper. Dropper, not hopper. face it this way so that it'll spit into the ice, because we're going to have ice and water go down there. Go ahead and take our hopper and shift click into here. So let's say we put something, gold. Why not gold? Gold, it'll come in here, go, there we go. Just making sure that was even. It'll go into the hopper, into the stream, around the corner. We get the gist. But to do that, we need a comparator. What a comparator does is it takes whatever is in the block behind it, and I'm going to need to dig up. Jump, there we go. It's going to take whatever in behind it, give out a signal. Make sure that's correct. We need a redstone repeater, because when it actually gives the signal, it doesn't put it into a redstone. So what we're going to have to do is do a repeater here. We're also going to put a repeater into this block. What that'll do is every time something comes in here, it'll go all the way around. So we need the redstone now. Redstone, redstone, redstone. It'll come out and tell this, hey, there was a signal, to spit it out. Also, what we need to do is we need to tell that signal to go back into itself to start the process over again. So, I do believe that's it. Let's go ahead and try it. When I put something in, there we go. That's exactly what we want. So every time we get an item down here, like say I'm auto fishing up there and I get a cool book, it'll come down here, going to the hopper, get spat out, come all the way down this corridor, which we will just go ahead and make now. So let's go ahead and ice this bad boy. We're going to ice. No. 1, 2. I gotta remember how many blocks it takes for water to actually affect it. Actually, no. I think I have an even better idea for this. I need a coal, which is why you see blocks here, but that's not gonna matter in a moment. I guess I should light up the area just in case mobs come and break my stuff. Let's go ahead and do. Forgot about that. You know what? This isn't going as well as I was planning it to go. There we go. Stop that. Break you. That's fine. You'll go down there. I have plenty of you. Not worried about it. Let's see how well, how far this shoots out right now, because I actually did not see. Let's drop you in there. Let's not be close by it. Okay, so right there. Actually, I guess I do want those there. And then, all of this comes out. And it needs to come here. So, let's hope this works. We're going to need, I think I'm going to need some half slabs, too. Oh, I am going to need half slabs, but I'll worry about that later. Let's just go ahead and fill this up with more blocks so that the water actually does not come out on the sides. There we go. And then ice, 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 and ice. Let's go ahead and track this. Wait, why? Why are you doing that? Why? Oh, that's why. That's fine. That's not fine. I'm going to have to put a different source of light down here, but for right now, that should work. Hoping that nothing actually here, let's put it here. That should be okay. If not, we'll deal with that later. Let's go ahead and go get some water now, which is just this, and break it. Oh, I have to take off my Frostwalker boots because that kind of hurts what I'm trying to do here. Take that, re-break it. And then put an ice block there. I think what we're going to do is make a half slab, not down here because I have no way of making a half slab. So unfortunately, once again, I will be back. All right, got the half slabs in. What I did was I went ahead and put up a wall here so that it doesn't spit out. Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cover this part completely. And that should be okay. Let's go ahead and pop some items in. Let's just go ahead with the golden nuggets that we have here. And let's see if it follows it down. There it goes. And it works. What I did was I put the half slab at the top so that the items can slide under onto some glass. Hit the next one since blocks only go about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8, put a slab here, put it around, and 8 is just enough. And I didn't actually calculate this out, but it puts it right here, which is just what I want. So right now, we're going to go into our redstone testing world. We're going to teach you how to build this, and then I'm just going to come back and build it just like I did with the people farm. I know they're villagers, but they're people, and that I can farm them, and I think it's very funny to say people farm. So let us go ahead into the testing world, and I will see you on the other side. You know what? I can't wait till I make enough stuff in this world to go, wow, that's a lot of stuff. I've been at this for a very long time, and you know what? This is just the beginning. So if you remember where we just came from, this is exactly what I built. The repeater? No, sorry. That's the repeater, the comparator, and my little... Well, this is four long, but still same concept. Comes out the little hole under there, down onto some ice, into some hoppers, and I have a dropper here. Now, at the time of building this is... Saturday, I think it's now Saturday. Saturday, so what day is it? Regardless, it's the Saturday before the pre-release is what I'm currently in right now. The Saturday before 1.11 comes out, which will be Monday. So we will be switching over to the 1.11 on Monday. So right now, this doesn't work. This only works in 1.11, so I'm still going to build it, though, since it works in 1.11. If I built it right now, at the moment, 1.10 and 1.9 makes it so that if this was here and shot everything up, it goes too fast. Yeah, every once in a while, you'll get some in here. Like, I tested this with carrots, and oh my god, carrots would fly over there, over there, over there, behind me. Some of them are on top, and then every once in a while, you would get in here. So I put 64 carrots in here, and I only got 28. However, with the diamond block, since I have a whole 64, let's go ahead and put them in the chest. This represents, have it represent the fish up in the fish farm. But go ahead and toss the fish inside. It comes out, spits it, and this is what we'll be making. Very simple, very easy. What's going on, and again, I will build it over there, but what's going on is the comparator once again sees what's behind it, gives out a signal. The signal does two things. It is coming into this repeater, because again, you need a repeater since doing a redstone will not work. So it goes into this block. This block is powered. It goes back into here to reset it, and this one comes into this block, which tells that to fire up. The blocks come up through the glass and pop into the hoppers, which once again, I'm pretty sure we're almost done now. 50, 52, 55, but you get the idea. They go up, we need an air block right there in the middle so that, you know, it has a place to pop up at. And that should be all 64, yep. So let's go ahead and build this. Again, very easy. I'm pretty much just going to rebuild this part, not that part, since we already did that in the redstone testing, I mean, in the actual world, this is the redstone testing world. We're just going to build this, and it should be easy. I will go ahead and reset my list, so if you want to build or want to follow along, go ahead and do so. This is a device made by Iskall, by the way. I do not take credit for this. I went to look for the smallest build. This one I built myself. I mean, a lot of people have built this one, so I don't know exactly who to give credit to, but I did figure this one out on my own. This I had to look up because I saw a man named Tangle Tech do one, and it just looked complicated as all get out. So I wanted a fast and quick version, and I'm so glad that 1.11 does this with the dropper, because at first you would have to go into a line which goes up against a fence post, and then that fence post would shut the water stream off or some deal. There's two pistons in here. It would push sand up, which would push it up through the thing because it was too fast at the moment. But sand makes it go much more slowly, which is why we're waiting to 1.11. So let's go ahead and build this. But once again, right after I clear my inventory of what you will need. All right, take a look at my bar. You're going to need, oh, you know what? I forgot one thing. There we go. That's it. That's everything you need. And that's, I'm not really including the glass, and I'm not really including any other hoppers than three, and I'll tell you why in a moment. But first, you're going to need one comparator, one hopper, two redstone repeaters, five pieces of redstone, two blocks. It doesn't matter what they are as long as they're not transparent. So don't use glass and don't use glowstone. And again, at least three hoppers. Now I say at least three because one hopper is going to be right here going into the dropper. And then two of them are going to be up here going into whatever output you are. So if you want to put a string of hoppers going out, that's fine. That would be your choice. I have one chest in here, but I'm just going to make it so it just goes into one chest. And again, I have glass here. You can make this as tall as you want. If you want it to go up to, like, let's say you have a floor or a second story building, and it was five blocks up, and you only needed maybe four or five. Does not matter. I don't think, yeah, lag's not even going to be an issue. Just make sure that you have it as a 3x3 block, and all of it, every last piece of it, is completely encased in glass. Right here, right here you'll see that under this is not glass. Everything above it is. Just make sure that this part is an air block and you'll be fine, but let's go ahead and make this. So right here we're going to have the dropper. Go ahead and make it standing up. You know what's standing up? When you see a hole in the middle, and this is where the dropper is going to go into. Now, normally, I would have, you know what, I am just going to go ahead and put another one here. So, I guess four, because right here is going to have glass on it. But something's going to go into this dropper, wherever you've hooked it up to, like my nice little fist catcher over here. And let's go ahead and set this today, because I don't like recording at night. There we go. Nice and day. All right. That's good. Sweet. Let's go ahead and put a dropper. I'm sorry, a redstone comparator. Again, we're going to put a repeater because, again, and let me show you why. Bam. Let's say I put that into a block. It's not going to work. Let's go ahead and finish this. Bam. Bam, it connects. That's problem number one. And even if it didn't connect, it would still not give out a long enough redstone length to power it. So that's why we use the repeaters. Bam. So let's go ahead and put you back into here. One, two. You're going to go into the second repeater, which goes into a block. And believe it or not, That is it. There's nothing else you have to do. We are actually all done except for the glass, which I will get to in a moment, but let's go ahead and drop in, let's just drop in these, because we don't need them anymore. I don't know exactly where I put them. Where did I put them? Oh, that's right. This does have to be on subtract mode. Let's make sure that that is on. There we go. Sorry about that. This right here does have to be on subtract mode. This on zero ticks, that's on zero ticks, and then you'll be fine. But make sure that's on subtract mode. Not subtract, subtract. Not subtract, subtract. Get the picture. Got it! So let's go ahead and drop in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yay! The reason that it keeps going on like that is because it drops it over into the hopper, which once again repeats the signal. But you see there that it works just fine. So let's go ahead and take our glass. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. Now, like I said, this can be as tall as you want it, as short as you want it. I'm going to make it, a decent size, not as tall as that one, just to let you guys know that it doesn't have to be that tall. So let's go up maybe one more. Yeah, let's go up one more. Fill it all in with blocks. And next, what we're going to do is we're going to go 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 1, 2. Go ahead and put a chest right on top. Go ahead and break this. Put the two hoppers that run into it. Next row is glass, glass, glass. Everywhere but the middle hopper. And then we layer it off. Simple as that. So let's make sure that it works, and you get to see it come up the elevator. So let's, let's just go ahead and drop in all 64. Or I have no idea where it went. Let's just go ahead and put a chest here. Bam. Let's get 64 TNT. That's nice and easy to see. I love it. I absolutely love it. Try not to stand by it just in case if you accidentally pick it up. I think you'll be fine, but why would you want to stand that close anyway? Look in here. There it is. All 64 will eventually make it. I'm telling you right now, if you're in 1.10 or lower, this will not work. You have to be in 1.11. If you're going to do it in 1.10 for some reason, that's fine. Just make sure that you follow the... Go on in the line and look for a design that has the fence gate, because that is the only ones that'll work. If you try it, this design in 1.10 or lower, it'll shoot it up too fast. As a matter of fact, let me go ahead and load this world up one more time, but I'm going to do it in 1.10, and I will show you myself. Whee! It looks like a volcano. But yeah... Now you guys see, let's go ahead and break that, put a chest, there we go, that's better. Like every so once in a while, it'll actually catch it. You see that some of them are even being just caught on the side of it. It's everywhere. It's over here, there, over there, I'm pretty sure some are behind me. Yeah, there's some right there. So, further proof that you should not build this at all in 1.10 or lower. Please, just go ahead and do 1.11. I mean, there's a mansion that's coming in 1.11. Who doesn't like mansions? I love mansions. I'm going to go find a mansion, and I'm totally going to put a base there after I do my underground fire igloo base thingy. It's going to be awesome. So... Well, I guess it's time to go back to the other world and build this currently. And I have to tell you, at the moment, it is not 1.10. It is still 1.11. I'm still going to build it so that it's ready, but I'm not going to be using it until, obviously, Monday. On Sunday will be the... by the time this episode comes out, we will have done the live stream... And it will have worked. So by the time you see this next episode, everything will be all in good. So we don't even have to worry about that. So let's go ahead to the other server, build this, God, I love how easy this part is. It just makes me so happy. All right, see you at the server. Okay, you're going to have to excuse the aesthetics and the rain, but I will deal with that later. Like, you see this? All this lovely granite? I think it's called granite. Granite, I'm going to make it the walls so that when you look down, you don't see grass. I mean, not grass. Dirt blocks and stone and whatever is there. Nope. Oh, there's a piece of granite, but it's not smooth granite. All of mine will be smooth, but that's not what we're here for today. We're here to see this in action on the server. Let's put you in some track mode. And let's go ahead and put you there. There we go. So, it looks like it worked, but it probably grabbed whatever was right there. So what we're going to do is we're going to... Actually, you know what? Let's go ahead and fish. Let's see if we can actually get some fish all the way up here and make sure it works. Now, keep in mind, being on this server, it may not go into that chest right there, but we're going to try it. So, hey, and I also get to do one side of the wall. One side of the wall. There we go. Yeah, because this part right here is still going to be the... polished andesite. But again, we'll deal with that later. So let's go ahead and fish. And, oh, look. That's a good sign. That's a really good sign. Let's go ahead and put a piece of glass right there. And it's looking good. I like it. All right, let's go fish. Grab the roof rod. And if you guys haven't seen this, what we're going to do is... Huh. Well then, what we're going to do is we're going to fix it. Let's go ahead and put the string right there. There you go. String. Alright. Let's go ahead and do some fishing. This may take a while. It shouldn't because I have lure 3 on here. Eat right quick. It's raining, so it should even work better. Why are you doing that? Do you hate that? Do you actually hate that? Something wrong here. Not looking good. There we go. I have no idea what was going on. But let's go ahead and keep this here. We'll wait for it to do it about 3 times. I won't make you guys wait. I'm pretty sure I'll just jump cut to after it does it the 3rd time. But I'm still hoping. Kind of hopeful. Yeah, I guess I'll see you when I get the 3rd fish. There's one, by the way. But I'll see you when I get the 3rd one. Okay, so we got the 3rd one. What I want to do is I want to hurry up and run over here to see if we see anything coming up. Let's hope so. Traveling down. Because even if it does just shoot all the way up, that's fine. We would still see it. But I actually don't even... see it. Because I don't think it goes that fast. Let's check the chest. Nothing. Snap! So, I guess we go down and find out what's wrong. See if we cannot fix the problem. Every time I go down here, I'm going to take out a section of the wall so that I can build it as I come down and check. Hopefully, I only have to do this a couple times. Let's see. Wait, what? Oh my god! Freaking boots! So it was Mia the whole time. Break. Break. Goes over. Shoots up. And that was completely my fault. So, you know what? I want to do this one more time. Just so I can see it from start to finish. See? Well, I just go ahead and pillar up. Aesthetics and problem solving at the same time. I love it. Alright, so let's go back to the fishing thing. And we'll only do one this time. Oh, I like how it just went the first time. Come on, give me a fish so we can see this right quick. Just once, I'd like you to give me a fish quickly when I say that. There we go. Alright, so let's run over here. There it is. So that's good. It works. It is just fine. You see that there's actually a puffer fish up there and a cod over here. But that lets me know it works. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to extend... I'm going to put a row of double chests along the side of this. One, two, then run two... Yeah, I'm going to put a row of double chests so I can come over and just pick from right here. There's going to be a wall right here, so they won't see any of this since this is the employees only area. But I like it. I'm so glad it works. I'm so glad that's good. We can move on to the next thing, which is... What were we going to... Oh, yeah. We need to take everything that's down here, put it over in the town somewhere, and not record when it is raining. So I'll be right back after the rain. We have people online, so we actually have to wait for them. Ah, that's what I was going to do. I'm so glad I even looked at that. We're going to put a plug-in on here. No, not a plug-in. The block. Command block. We're going to put a command block on here that makes it so that when one person sleeps, you can... turn off the rain? What am I trying to say here? Wow, I'm flubbing words today. We can turn it from night to day, and which will also turn off the rain. There we go. That's what I wanted to say. So let me go up here and grab you guys. Yeah, I'm okay with this. Grab you guys. Get these off of here, because I kind of like those fish. And we didn't think so. And I guess I'll be right back after we... stop the rain in the dark time, because OBS does not like either of them. Alright, it's nice and sunny. No more rain. And fun news, we're actually at 1.11 right now. That's right, it is Monday. And so let's go ahead and show you what I've been doing in that time. So as you'll see, first thing you notice is that yes, I've actually started the building for this. That's floor one. I don't think each floor will be that tall because the bottom is more of the starting area, because I needed it to be tall enough for the glass elevator, which we will get to see. But look at the front. I really like how I made the front because it looks like a convenience store with the handles, both entrance and exits. I like this. I'm not going to change this at all. I'll put some windows in, then I'll put a sign to show you what is on each floor. But I absolutely love it. But that's not what we're here for. Let's finish off this episode by looking at this. Yeah, I know you already saw it before, but it works. So let's take a note here. 24, 7, 1, 3, and 2 items. Got it. Let's go over here and get my fishing rod. Also, yes, this has changed. I'm just going to have to teach you how to make it in another episode. So episode 25, this right here should be 24. In 25, I will teach you how to make this and why it works. Normally, when you go on YouTube and look for a tutorial, they tell you how to build it, but I'm going to tell you how to build it and why it works. Because I think it's very interesting of why this keeps breaking every time there is a new update. Because even in the last one, when we changed it to the other design from my very simple and extremely missed 5x3, because now this is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so it's a little longer, which isn't bad, but it's taller. And unfortunately, it has to be, because now it involves redstone that has to do with the door opening and then these coming down. It's very complicated, but I can simplify it so it's a little bit easier to understand. That way, if you want to go ahead and make your own, you can go and, using the knowledge that I shall provide, build your own and probably make it smaller than what I have here. I will continue to try to refine this, but if you guys can find a smaller design for this, please tweet me, put it down in the comment section, something, let's make this smaller, or find a different design altogether. But let's go ahead and get my fishing rod out. We're going to turn it on. That's right, turn it on. Sorry, guys. Yeah, I know. In the back there is a note block. I have a block over up here. Even though it's a half block, it still counts as a full block, so it will not make sound. If you want to make sound, just go ahead and get rid of this. I will not, because I'm recording, and it's very annoying to listen to. It's just, trust me, it's better for us all if I not break that block. Anywho, when you throw it, you're going to throw it, and you're going to aim at the bottom of the note block. It will work just fine. It's going to bop up and down, and we are going to wait till I actually catch this as a fish, because what we're going to do is we're going to follow it. Come on, give us a fish. We need you to give us something. There we go. All right. Oh, nope. For some reason, it came to me. Let's turn this off. I do believe, unfortunately, oh yeah, that's right. Unfortunately, let's go ahead and drop the fish down into, drop it down into, why are you not going inside the hopper? Oh, bugger, that's right. So I built it in 111. And the hoppers don't work. I have to replace all the hoppers to update them. So I guess I'll be right back after I do that. Ah, this is becoming more work than I wanted it to be. Okay, I'm over here. I want to show you. I took everything out of here so that there's nothing in there. So let's go back over to the fish farm. Grab our fishing rod. It's already on, so go ahead and aim at the bottom. Right click. There we go. And this time, it should work and go down without any problems. This is multiplayer ready, so there shouldn't even be any problems with ticks or, I mean, game ticks or anything else. Give me a fish. I'm actually going to need a fish this time really quickly. You think that Lure 3 would give us a fish, but whatever. Just hurry up and give me my fish. Anytime now. No, please take your time. I'm on. All right, there it goes. Here we go. Come down here. We should see it come up slowly. And 1.11 is going to be great. I've already seen the llamas and everything, and I'm going to go ahead and turn this off, actually. There we go. I've already seen the llamas and everything. Well, not everything. I guess I just saw the llamas, and I want to make sure this works. And just to make sure that I'm not joking or nothing's fishy or anything, bam, 1.11/vanilla. Right now, the plugins aren't in, so I'm going to have to wait till Saturday before Spigot comes out with 1.11 Spigot, I guess. And then we'll have, you know, our other plugins, so everybody will be happy then. But you know what? That's going to do it for this episode. I'm going to stand in front of my I'm going to stay in front of my convenience store. Convenience store for fish. But anyways, I will see you guys. Let's see. Today is... Yeah, it comes out on Thursday. Yeah, I guess I'll see you guys on Sunday for the live stream. I will make sure that I have enough bricks so we can actually finish the fire igloo. But I'm having a lot of fun over here. So, I guess... Yeah, I will see you Sunday. Until then, goodbye.